الشيطان إن الشيطان عدو لكم فاتخذوه عدوا. الشيطان is an enemy and الشيطان is real. You know, الشيطان is real. Not with the you know, I mean, there's hadith that there's horns of shaitan and things, but you know, the popular imagination has created this image that makes people think that it's a joke. Shaitan is real. There's dark forces working in the world, and they whisper in the hearts of people, and sometimes the whispering become audible, like hallucinations, and they do wretched things. Shaitan will get people, and Shaitan loves to humiliate us. This is his favorite thing. He loves to, because he hates us. He has envy in his heart for the station that we were given. He has envy in his heart, and the envier wants to see, he wants to see the source of his envy. He wants to see him grovel. He wants to see him be humbled by the world. He wants to see him in a destitute situation. And this is Shaitan's, he hates when people get close to Allah. But he's tricky, you see. First he'll get you, his first strategy is kufr. That's his first strategy. And if he can't get kufr from you, then he tries to get nifaq. If he can't get nifaq from you, then he tries to, like, he tries to get ma'asiyah, right? And his favorite one is bid'ah, to get innovation. But ma'asiyah, if he can't get bid'ah from you, he'll get ma'asiyah. You know, just like sinfulness, stealing, lying, cheating, adultery, whatever. He wants to get that, to humiliate you. If he can't get any of these things, if he sees that you're on a strong path, then he gets really serious. Seriously. Because those people, they're easy for him to get. He gets very serious. And what he does is he gets the riya. He wants to put in your heart this sense of superiority, that you're better than other people, that you're a pious person, that you're righteous. And he starts telling you how great you are. And these things will occur in the heart if you're doing things seriously. If you're on a serious path, this is how he comes. And if you don't have the ammunition to deal with him, then he can really wreak havoc on the human heart. Right? He wreaks havoc. So mujahadatu shaitan, the kibr in the soul. And the last thing to leave the hearts of the siddiqun is the hubr riyasa. And the Prophet ﷺ said, al-mal wal-jah, right? Mal-mal wal-jah adarru li deen al-mar'i min bayni ja'ini fi ghanam. That wealth, material wealth, materialism, and stature. Oh, stature being held up. You know, sheikh so-and-so, or doctor so-and-so, or whatever it is. You know, all these things people want, you know, in the world, the pomp and circumstance of the world, really. It's nothing. It's nothing. It's empty. The world is empty. It's vacuous. Really, it's empty. It has an empty, there's nothing there. Rumi said, when you speak, always remember you have an audience of one. You know, who are you trying to impress? No, seriously, who are you trying to impress? You know, in the Meditations, Marcus Aurelius, he says, there's people who say they don't care about the people of today, but they care about their legacy. He said, these people are only fooling themselves, because the same fools that will be around 100 years to be reading their legacy are the same fools that are around today, you know. And that's why, you know, if you be a celebrity with God, all these people want to